Hello, welcome to Nasal Academy, episode 4. My name's Tammy, and everything here, it's all about boosting and enhancing our body, our health, our wellness, with the nose. Yeah, and all kinds of other good things. So anyway, today, I probably won't talk as long, I'm hoping. I don't think I will. I just thought I would go, you know, again, it's Easter weekend. It's, we're in the middle of the coronavirus pandemic. People are talking about how we're going to, you know, when things are going to happen. But we do know that there's a lot of products that aren't at our disposal. Now, I can't tell you how to make your own toilet paper and, or paper towels or napkins. All I can say is whatever you do, don't waste them. However, there is apparently going to be, it's predicted, although I haven't really seen a lot of it anywhere, hand sanitizer. And as you know, I'm very much about using oils, lifestyle. And so I'm going to give you a suggestion here for hand sanitizer. And if for whatever reason you don't have accessibility to these particular oils and would like me to make it up for you, I'm happy to do it. Yeah, I'll do it. I'll make it work. You know, I'll make it worth your while. Meaning I won't charge you a lot of money for it. It's just, yeah, maybe cost plus shipping, cost plus a couple bucks over plus shipping. Yeah. Just something inexpensive, but just so that you have something usable. However, I'm going to give you the suggestions anyway. And if you have access to them, awesome. So my suggestions for your hand sanitizer would be Raven Sara. Okay, that's Sara, A-R-A-V-E-N-S-A-R-A, Raven Sara. The reason I say that is there's another oil called Raven Sara, not that one, Raven Sara. That plus hyssop decumbens. There's a couple of different types of hyssop, so it has to be hyssop decumbens and petitgrain. And it's a very, you know, it's called petitgrain. It's not, there's not an orange substitute for it. It's actually called petitgrain. So petitgrain, hyssop decumbens, and Raven Sara in aloe vera gel. And the aloe vera actually hastens the absorption, the assimilation. So it gets into your system. And it does, it disinfects your hands. And because this is a nasal academy, smell it. Put it on. Smell it because you will actually get the benefit because the olfactory system has a relationship. It interacts with the immune system. So, it, and not to mention the fact, the more we breathe through our nose and the deeper our breaths can be, it's important. Let's put it that way. It's very, very important to breathe through our nose. It's, we're trying to stimulate nitric oxide production, nitric oxide in nasal nitric oxide, which is very important for lung health. And trying to be animated in these times, but it's very important to lung health. And so these particular oils will actually benefit you in that regard. Petitgrain has more of an antiseptic quality, but it also supports vitamin D, so I would just want to say it like that. So it helps kind of support vitamin D production, and to a degree. So does the Raven Sara. So the combination of the two actually work really, really well to support vitamin D, which is necessary for quality immune function. And as I mentioned, the three of them combined really help with the respiratory system. So they help with the clearing, keeping the sinuses open, supporting nasal nitric oxide, and preventing any viruses from settling into the chest. And because petitgrain is an antiseptic, it has more of a, sorry for that noise, any other potential co-infections. So that's what I would do if you did anything else while I'm thinking about it. So besides those three, you could actually throw, I'm always cautious with the eucalyptus because of the the 1-8-cianol in it or the eucalyptol because it doesn't go too well with it. Actually, it doesn't go well at all, truthfully. No, I'm not going to play around with this one. It doesn't go well if you're taking some sort of central nervous system depressant. That's the reason why I don't. So it's called, CNS depressant, which is a sedative. So if you're taking any type of sedative, please do not use any eucalyptus, any. Okay, that's really very important. That's the reason why I hesitate to offer that suggestion. However, if you're not taking as type of sedative, then by all means, put some eucalyptus radiata in that because it contains the eucalyptol, which is also called 1-8-cianol, which is very beneficial to nitric oxide synthase as well, which is necessary for immune and respiratory function. So, with that said, if you need any help getting a sanitizer, let me know. Otherwise, those are your four oils. But there is a caution with the eucalyptus. Please, please be kind to yourself. Please be safe and don't mix it with a sedative. Okay? I've talked about it before and I'll just briefly mention it now. There are different types of adverse reactions. It's not necessarily the rash or the itching, the sneezing, and any. It could also be nausea, headache. Those will be adverse reactions. It could very well create an additive effect. And in this case, taking it with a sedative would be more of an additive effect. So you're going to be groggier. You're going to have more of that sluggish hangover when you come to. And also, there's the potential for what's known, what I refer to as a silent adverse reaction, which is alterations happening to the epigenome because technically it's wired to adapt. And so if there's changes that are occurring, there's just switches that are changing, and we may not know anything until further down the line. So this is the significance of working with nature and chemicals, which is how nature communicates. So one more time, petigreen, hyssop decumbens, ravensara, and then eucalyptus radiata. If, say it with me, you're not taking a sedative. All right, you guys, take care. Thanks for watching and happy Easter.